We got your pennants. We got it all right here. Official Corley Motors merchandise.
All right. Well, let's talk to you. Maybe
drive
you have
your own derby car by. What can I get you?
So why are the lights down here? I'm looking for a good souvenir. Seen any vultures around here? Better let you get back to work. Let's do this.
Why are the lights down here?
We got a demolition derby tonight. First prize is a vintage Corley hardtail, completely restored by the old man himself. Yep.
Okay, so it looks like this is part of the whole Rip Burger plan. Is that the prize is going to be a bike. What's this big arena doing way out here?
Corley built the Smashatorium so his employees could have some wholesome entertainment nearby. He sure took care of his employees. I got no idea what's going to happen to us now that he's gone.
So in order to take care of his employees, he created a monster truck stadium. Well, that's appropriate considering the atmosphere we're working with. I'm looking for a good souvenir.
Well, good souvenirs is all I got. What can I fix you up with?
Something small, furry, and yellow. How about that little car there? Bunnies, plenty of them. Actually, let me think about it.
Something small, furry, and yellow.
Sorry, this is the only set of teeth I got. Dang, there goes another one.
How about a little car?
How about that little car there?
It's small, but it's not cheap, my friend. You better just take it for a test drive to make sure.
Bunnies and plenty of them?
Bunnies and plenty of them.
You want bunnies? I got your bunnies. How much you got on you?
Can I just take them out for a test drive?
I think you may not be ready for the kind of commitment that comes with a Corley Bunny Value Pack. Sorry, son.
Oh, okay, well, sorry. Let's see, what do those pennants say on them?
Can't beat a Corley, they say. Kind of ironic, actually, considering how he died. Still, look great on your bedroom wall.
No walls. My bike is my home.
We could set you up with a little pole so you could make a flag, you know, for your back seat.
I'll think about it.
Okay, so we'll hold off on this one for
actually,
a second.
Let me think about it.
He who hesitates goes home with Jack, and his kids hate him.
Thanks for the warning.
Ah, well, good thing Ben doesn't have kids. So what's in the hat?
I don't know. Came filled with it. Probably some sort of packing material. Packs a punch, I'll tell you that much.
He is literally drinking packing material. That can't be good for your body. All right.
Seen any vultures around here?
Nah, we don't have much of a vulture problem here, even though their hideout is right up the road. They stay pretty much locked up in there. Not very social.
Okay.
Better let you get back to work.
All right, matey.
So, here's what you can do.
Our bunnies come with batteries included.
Remember how he said that we could take the car for a test drive?
Lovable little bunnies.
Grab the test.
Sure. So, take it for a spin. Just don't go out of range.
Okay, so what we're going to do? We're going to go out of range.
We got your t-shirts here.
Way out of range.
All sizes and colors. Fill our handy beverage hats with your drink of choice.
Looks like it's getting weak.
Oh, great. You killed the batteries.
Well, darn. Okay, that's a problem. So, can we
You'll
do anything with the bunny?
You'll be keeping cold and looking bold.
Pick up the bunny. Hey, cool. We caught him off guard. So now we have a bunny. We have a little Energizer bunny. Don't you feel proud, Alex?
I do.
Well, you should feel proud, Alex. Why? Because this solves our little problem. So, if we go out to the minefield, we now have something to test the minefield. And for all the people who are going to scream at us going, what? Yes, it's cute, it's cuddly.
The minefield's been replanted. Tidy little vultures. Those weapons were out of weight.
And we don't care, because he's cute, he's cuddly, and he's going to test this minefield for us. How far will we get, Alex? How far? Think we got another couple of inches? Wow, he got pretty far.
Boom.
Okay. But you'll notice that we had another problem. When we came back, the minefield had been replanted.
Yeah.
So we're going to need a lot more bunnies. But it just so happens that when it went boom, its battery was pristinely preserved. I'm not sure how that happened, but it did. So now we've solved our little car problem because it died. Let's go ahead and put this battery to good use and put it back in the car. There we go.
You, big fella, come give our derby car a spin.
I wish I could, but your car's dead.
Your special smashatorium adventure.
That should put some life into it.
All right, so now we can use it again.
Take it for a spin. Just don't go out of range.
All you gotta do is move it all the way over here out of range.
So they'll shut up on the long drive home.
Oh, hi.
Okay, that's far enough, bud.
How about let's go through here? Oops.
Hey, don't go in there. Now look what you did. The entrance is all the way through the factory. Hang on, little buddy. Daddy's coming.
In other words, it's gonna take him a while to get back. Bunnies. So let's go ahead and just grab the bunny box. All things in games can be achieved through thievery. Well, all worthwhile things can be achieved through thievery. All right, back to the Vulture's hideout. We should now have enough bunnies to be able to figure out the minefield. However, we got to be quick about this. Because we don't want them all to go out into the minefield in all random directions, right? Yeah. We want to make sure that they follow a specific path. So let's go ahead and just go ahead and use the box. Yes. Yes, this is the dumbest music that could possibly be used with these bunnies, but we don't care. Okay, so last bunny. Sorry, guys, I cut off the music for you. But now we have 12 new bunnies to be able to help us figure out the minefield. Okay, so now we know that we can step as far as there.
I don't want to set off any of these.
Okay. Set this off again. And now Alex begins the tedious process of making our way through the minefield. How long will this one take? Only time will tell. Okay, that's quite a bit of distance. There we go.
I don't want to set off any of these boys.
Okay, so now we're as far as we could possibly go so far. Bring out the bunny. And how far will this one go, Alex? Oops.
I hate sub.
Next one. Yes, you could technically solve this puzzle, people, with two bunnies. I've done it. But this one is taking a little longer. Oh, there we go.
That's the guy I was telling you about, Susie.
You sure?
Yeah, that's the guy who killed my father.
All right, vultures, rack 'em up!
Crap.
Let's rip him quick.
Listen, Mo, you're making a big mistake.
Oh, Ben, you're right. We shouldn't do this quickly. We should draw this out, don't you think, Susie?
Hey, I got all night. You heard her, kids. Let's draw this out.
We have literally been drawn and quartered. And at any point, we could be ripped apart.
Thanks.
But the other problem is that Mo thinks we killed her dad.
Yeah.
So, your father was killed by Ripper, not me.
Your father.
Don't you dare talk about my father, you heartless bastard.
Okay, Corley and I.
I said shut up about my dad.
Malcolm wants you to take over his company.
I said shut up about my dad.
Yeast. I'm losing my temper, Maureen. Let's see. Okay, that's... Okay.
Okay, that's enough.
Not quite.
Oh! Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and say this for the record. You can't lose in this one.
You can?
They will not let you be drawn and quartered. Sorry. But I'm innocent.
I'm innocent.
You're in something, all right.
Well, we have to figure out a way to be able to tell her that we didn't do it, so...
I'm losing my temper, Maureen.
I'm losing my temper, Maureen.
And you're about to lose much more.
Okay, let me go or else.
Let me go or else.
Or else what?
I'll stick the polecats on you. I'll tear this place apart. I'll call you names. I'll get blood all over your driveway.
I'll get blood all over your driveway.
I'll get blood all over your driveway.
That's good for the landscaping, actually.
Let me go or else.
Let me go or else.
Or else what?
I'll stick the polecats on you.
I'll stick the polecats on you.
The polecats are in jail, Ben. You put them there, remember?
Or else?
Let me go, or else.
Or else what?
Tear this place apart.
I'll tear this place apart.
Ironic choice of words, Ben.
All right, let me go, or else.
Let me go, or else.
Or else
what?
There's
only one thing that works, Alex. I'll call you names.
I'll call you names.
Like what?
Mink farmer. Diaper dynamo. Freaky toaster-loving old maid. Rat bike riding, rubber covered vultures. Now, we could answer the right way, which is, if people remember, one of these names is actually the name that Corley called his daughter. Could that be Meat Farmer?
Meat Farmer.
Nope, that was not it. Alright, so let me go or else.
Let me go or else.
Let me go
or else what?
Unfortunately, you don't get any other reactions other than this.
I'll call you names.
So let's go ahead and go with the one that Coralie actually did call her, which is Diaper Dynamo.
Diaper Dynamo.
How did you hear that name?
Your father. He told me just before he died.
You bludgeoned my father and then talked about old times?
I didn't kill him. Ripberger did. A photographer took pictures, but her camera was stolen by the same thug that came after you.
I still have that role.
Well, develop it, would you, while I still fit in my clothes?
Okay, you stay here.
Hey.
Ow! Meanwhile...
Sorry.
Yeah, well, don't sweat it.
I'm gonna get Ripberger even if I die trying.
No. We have to expose Ripberger at the shareholders' meeting. That way, we take him down, we save my gang, and your father gets his dying wish. You take over Corley Motors.
Ripberger canceled the shareholders' meeting. He made a statement to the press that there'd be no meeting until the murderers were brought to justice.
So, no shareholders' meeting until we're both dead?
That could be arranged.
Okay, so here we go. Faking Ben and Maureen's death.
Ginormous
one,
metal codpiece.
Adrian Ripberger, in a desperate attempt to lure our Maureen out of hiding, has developed the following lame-ass scheme. First prize at tonight's smash-up derby is a vintage hardtail that Mo restored with her dad. Rip hopes Mo will try to nab said bike on account of her sentimental attachment to it. So Ben and Mo play along, put on disguises, and enter the demolition derby, which ends tragically when their cars explode and both are presumed dead.
Question.
Please save your questions until the end. Now,
explosives
in Mo's car can only be triggered by a head-on collision with Ben's car. This
they
ejector seat projects Mo clear of the explosion, and she parachutes to safety.
Don't you think someone will notice her ejecting out of her car?
No, they'll all be watching you running around on fire.
Yeah, that's another question.
Wait, I'm running around on fire?
When your car explodes, you climb from it in flames and run around the stadium distracting the audience. In your cute little asbestos suit, of course.
Crap.
That's some plan.
All right, then. Let's go blow your little darlings up.
This is really elaborate trying
Hang
to stage
on
our deaths.
Chili dogs, cause it's time to start.
I see a lot of
the
problems with this, Alex.
Smashatorium amateur driver ultimate destruction Maximum Carnage Marathon.
We get it.
Let's meet our crash cage gladiators.
Oh, you're gonna love this. So
mysterious looking hooded figure wouldn't give us
his
real name.
Can you tell who we are?
He prefers to be known as the Unknown Avenger. And that's just fine with us, isn't it, folks?
And then right next to us is Bo.
Now I'm just embarrassed for them. Who do they think they're fooling with those ludicrous disguises?
And next to him is another masked newcomer. Please give a big smashatorium salute to the princess of Pile-Up, Doreen Schmorley.
Doreen Schmorley.
All right, boys.
Oh, and make sure to have your
have
awesome demolition derby
tonight,
with the proto
code. A deadly looking team known as the Boom Boom Brothers.
Try and get away.
Yeah, so we have to deal with these guys again. Oh, poor
All
big
right
guy.
Now, are you ready to see some reckless driving? Are you ready to see some unnecessarily violent destruction?
No.
Then let the demolition derby begin.
So, spoiler alert, the yellow car is is
Hang
us.
Hang on, Mo. Here
yeah,
I come.
So, oh, actually, my bad. The red car is us. Okay. But the yellow car is Doreen. So, or Maureen. You get what I mean, people. Yeah. So, this is, in my opinion, one of the more complicated sections of the game. Because you actually have to pilot this. And it plays just as rickety as you might think it does.
What are you doing? Get over here and nail me.
I'm trying, okay? This thing plays really bad. Alright, so let's just get out of here. Oh, ow. What's over here? Maybe we could find some protection here. Okay, well, you can get off the ramp. Oh, ow, 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 ow. Do not get too close to the blue car, otherwise the Boom Boom Brothers...
Watch out for the Boom Boom Brothers, Mo.
...will take it out on you. So here's what you want to do. Believe it or not. All you have to do is rig it so you go off the ramp and... Believe it or not... These things stall when you hit them on top.
Yeah.
So.
That car stalled when I bounced off the roof. Looks like these babies have a glass jaw.
Exactly. So now that I have this.
I can't avoid these other cars forever.
I know, Mo, shut up. I'm not trying to avoid you. I promise. But what we gotta do is we gotta find a way to stall the Boom Boom Brothers so we can stage our little wreck. So here's what we're gonna do. We're going to use this orange car as a means to be able to get our task done. So we gotta intentionally push it up the ramp. And it's harder than you think, Alex.
Is.
Okay, so now we can do this. Woo!
Okay, Boom Boom Brothers, it's all over.
So, miraculously, we went over air. And now they're stalled.
Are you taking a nap?
Why should both of them have to be in the same
I know, right?
Okay,
makes
Mo,
no sense.
Time for our big finale.
That's why I call him Pinky in the Brain. All right, so, boom!
Oh.
For the record, I love how Ben runs.
Wait, what's that? It's the Unknown Avenger, and he's on fire! Let's give him a hand, folks. That looks painful.
Do you think?
We really should put him out right away, but what a show, huh?
Yeah, they care so much about me, right? So...
Still no sign of Miss Morley.
Let's just go over here really quick. Oh, cool. I thought I had to talk to them first. We have to create a distraction, right? What bigger distraction than lighting the place on fire?
Ben, quit clowning around and make a diversion.
I am a diversion.
No offense, but we need a bigger one. The bike is guarded.
Who cares about the bike?
Mo says it's important, so we're not leaving without it.
All right, I'll see what I can do, but I'm burning at both ends here.
All right, so this actually kind of solves the problem.
Ben, oh, you gotta make a big, big diversion.
I heard you the first time, trust me, Bill.
We did, Susie, shut up. Okay, so I believe maybe...
I guess the Avenger never heard of stop crawling.
There we go. So what bigger distraction, Alex, than lighting the place on fire?
Yeah.
So now they can get the bike out of the way. Oh, good. They finally fixed their car.
Now, squish that firefly while he's hot.
And now we have to deal with the Boom Boom Brothers.
Look at him run.
Well, this is going to be a problem now.